I'm Thomas, and I'm about to answer the top 5 most frequently asked questions on the Kamoer FX-STP continuous duty dosing pump, starting with, what are the dimensions? The FX-STP comes in right around 5 1/4 inches long, 3 1/4 inches wide, and 5 inches tall, which is pretty dang small for a purpose-built continuous duty dosing pump. And while it doesn't have any keyhole mounts, it is definitely small enough to fit on a variety of dosing pump and controller board shelves with room to spare. How do you calibrate it? And how often should you do aforementioned calibration? How often you're going to want to calibrate is going to depend on a few factors. However, there are a few instances when you absolutely should be doing a calibration. When you first receive and set up your pump, it's going to need to be calibrated. Anytime you change that peristaltic tubing or the dosing head, it's going to need to be calibrated. And if it's been in operation for longer than 3 months, it's a good idea to recalibrate to make sure things continue running smoothly. Calibration is really easy and you can do it right on board using the control knob and the screen on the FX-STP, or you can do it through the Kamoer remote app. You will need a graduated cylinder as well, and you're gonna wanna pick one up that's large enough to hold the volume that you intend to set your flow rate to. For example, if I will most likely be setting up my pump to somewhere around 60 milliliters a minute, then I'll wanna get the 100 milliliter graduated cylinder. You'll also want a cup of RODI water to perform the calibration with. Once you're all set up, you can go into settings and select calibration, select the speed, or if you already have the pump set to your desired flow rate before going into calibration, it'll already have that correct speed set for you. Next, prime the pump if you haven't already, then select the number of seconds you'd like the calibration test to run. The longer the better, so a full 60 seconds is always best. Put the outlet tube in your graduated cylinder and tap start add. Once the pump has stopped, you can read the volume of water that it dispensed into the graduated cylinder and then enter that volume into the app and you're done. When or how often should you change that peristaltic tubing that's on the pump? The tubing is rated for 2,000 hours of continuous use, which is right around that 3-month mark, but it's likely gonna last longer than that if you're using the pump at lower flow rates. As a general rule of thumb though, it's always best to change it out every 3 to 4 months, just to make sure the pump's always working perfectly. Is the Kamoer remote app easy to use? Yeah, it's actually really easy to use. Once you log into the app and add the FX-STP, the main screen shows the current flow rate, the RPMs that the motor is currently running, as well as the amount of runtime on the peristaltic tubing that's currently in the pump, and a start button. You can tap on the blue numbers to enter your desired flow rate and then tap start and you're good to go. You can click the gear icon in the top right to access settings where you can also rename the pump, perform a calibration, perform a factory reset, or remove the device. It is super simple and intuitive. I actually prefer the app over the onboard if I'm doing things like calibration, but if I want to just quickly change, let's say the flow rate for my calcium reactor effluent, doing it with this knob is awesome. It's got little clicks and everything, super satisfying. Can you use push connect fittings with this pump? Absolutely. So if you wanted to run semi-flexible standard RODI tubing for say your calcium reactor to the FX-STP, this is how you're gonna do it. The FX-STP itself comes with a pair of 1/8 inch to 1/4 inch barbed adapters, as well as both 1/8 inch and 1/4 inch tubing. So all you're gonna need to pick up are a pair of 1/4 inch Murlock push connect unions and barbed stem adapters. Connect the 1/8 inch to 1/4 inch barbed adapters to the FX-STP using the included 1/8 inch tubing, then cut to short lengths of 1/4 inch tubing and attach the Murlock barbed stem adapters to the FX-STP barbed adapters. Then slide on the push fittings and your FX-STP is ready for that rigid 1/4 inch tubing for your calcium reactor so you can run it on easy mode. With those big questions out of the way, hopefully you now know whether or not the FX-STP matches your reefing mantra. And if it does, you can go ahead and pick one up for yourself by clicking right here.